सो हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ पीआईबी 24/7। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड इन दिस सेशन गाइस आई विल ब्रिंग टू यू फाइव इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द पीआईबी न्यूज व्हिच आर इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर ईएसआई सेक्शन ऑफ आरबीआई ग्रेड बी। सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन, इफ यू आर न्यू हियर, डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन, एंड ऑल्सो यू कैन जॉइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप फॉर डेली क्विजेस एंड अपडेटेड इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट द डेली सेशंस। ऑलराइट, and this is a brief information about me. I have done BSc Physics honors from Delhi University and also have cleared various government exams, and you can follow me on Instagram for exam related queries. So let's begin with the very first question, which is about the 12th BRICS Summit 2020. So the question is, consider the following statements regarding BRICS Summit 2020 and you have to identify the incorrect statements. Okay, so let's discuss about the BRICS Summit guys 2020. So this was the 12th edition of the BRICS Summit, which was hosted by Russia. Okay, and the document which was adopted during this summit was Moscow Declaration. Alright, Moscow Declaration was the document that was adopted after the summit, and it was of course hosted by Russia, and the edition was number 12. And what was the theme? The theme was BRICS Partnership for Global Stability, Shared Security and Innovative Growth. Okay, BRICS Partnership for Global Stability, Shared Security and Innovative Growth was the theme of BRICS Summit 2020. And these are some basic important points which we can see from the BRICS Summit 2020. So all the members nations agreed to support the WHO initiative. So there is an initiative of WHO which is named as Access to COVID-19 Tools Accelerator. Access to COVID-19 Tools Accelerator is an initiative of WHO. So the BRICS member nations have agreed to support this initiative. And what this initiative is all about? So under this initiative, various international organizations, like we have Gavi, we have Global Fund, we have World Bank. So there are various government international organizations which are providing funds to the low-income nations for their fight against the COVID-19. And these funds will help them in developing vaccines and to develop their health systems. Okay, so this initiative is ACTA Act A, or we can say Access to COVID-19 Tools Accelerator, is an initiative of WHO supported by various international organizations, where they will provide they are providing fundings to the low income nations in their fight against COVID-19. All right, other than this, BRICS nations emphasize the importance of this very important convention on the prohibition of the development, production and stockpiling of the biological and toxic weapons. So this convention guys came into force in the year 1975, and currently there are 183 parties to this convention, and India is also signatory to this convention, which says that we should not develop, we should not produce and we should not stockpile the biological and toxic weapons. So BRICS members ne bola that we will also emphasize this convention. All right. And there was a strategy that was known, that's very important, BRICS counter-terrorism strategy, that was drafted by Russia. This strategy guys was drafted by Russia, and as the name suggests, ye terrorism ko counter karne ke liye tha. This strategy is there for countering the terrorism in the BRICS nation, and all the BRICS member nations have agreed to adopt this strategy that has been drafted by Russia. Okay, and moving ahead, so what was the India's stand at the summit? So in the terrorism, India emphasized confronting the countries which are supporting and sponsoring terrorism. India ne indirectly Pakistan ko target karte hue aisa bola that the countries which are supporting and sponsoring the terrorism, we have to target those countries, we have to stop, we have to counter them. India acknowledged Russia's support to the BRICS counter terrorism strategy, because this strategy has been drafted by Russia. And for the COVID-19 pandemic, India addressed the issue of cooperation among the members of BRICS countries. Jo BRICS countries hai unke aapas mein jab cooperation hoga, then we will be able to fight better against the COVID-19, because BRICS nation accounts for 42% of the world's population. Jo BRICS member nations hai, BRICS countries hai, usme puri duniya ka 42% world ka population hai. So agar hamare beech mein cooperation acha hoga, then we will be able to fight better against the COVID-19. And since 42% of the world's population resides in these countries, as I told you, and India also highlighted the increasing scope of trade among the BRICS nation. Alright, so this was the India stand, and now, and India stand guys, Robin will ask you in the exam. This is just for the, you can use these points in your essay wala jo paper hota hai, usme aap in points ka use kar sakte hain.
You just have to remember the important points about the BRICS summit. Number one is the BRICS counter-terrorism strategy. Then the BRICS members have agreed to follow, to adopt this strategy of WHO Act A. And then they emphasize the importance of this convention, which is there, which says that we should not develop, produce and stockpile the biological and toxin weapons. Right. So now let's come back to the question. So we have to identify the incorrect statements. All the member nations adopted the BRICS counter-terrorism strategy drafted by India. So is that drafted by India? No, it is drafted by Russia, which means this statement is incorrect. Member nations were agreed to support the United Nations initiative Access to COVID-19 Tools Accelerator. So yes, they were agreed to support this initiative, but guys, this initiative is not of United Nations, it is of the WHO, which means this statement is also incorrect. And the summit was hosted by China. No, it was hosted by Russia. And in the year 2021, we all know it will be hosted by India. Okay, because it goes according to the acronym BRICS. This year it is Russia, next year it will be China, next year it will be India, then we'll have China, South Africa, is tarike se chalta hai. So therefore, the correct answer will be what? All are incorrect. Option E will be the correct answer. And now let's move on to the question number 2. So the question number 2 is, which organization has launched this app? And the name of the app is what? Ananda app, for agents to facilitate the services of selling insurance policies digitally. So already jo is app ka basic objective hai wo question mein given hai, that is to facilitate the services of selling the insurance policies digitally. So this app, Ananda app, has been launched guys by LIC. LIC of India has launched this app Ananda, and Ananda has a full form also, Atmanirbhar Agents New Business Digital Application. Atmanirbhar Agents New Business Digital Application is the full form of Ananda. So you have to remember the full form of Ananda also. Okay. And this app, what will this app do? So it will facilitate the process of policy buying and selling, which will be completely paperless and digital. Right. And talking about LIC, it is headquartered in Mumbai. And of course, the chairperson is Mr. M.R. Kumar. And LIC is one of the domestic systematically important insurers identifying the Praveen Kutumbe Committee. The committee, name of the committee was Praveen Kutumbe Committee, and the other two DSIIs are LIC, GIC and New India Insurance. New India Assurance. So these are the three domestic systematically important insurers in our country. These are too big to fail. And so therefore the correct answer is what? Option A, LIC. Okay, Life Insurance Corporation of India. And now let's move on to question number 3. So you have to consider the following statements regarding Satat initiative. So there is an initiative which is known as Satat of the Ministry of Natural Gas and Petroleum. So you have to consider these statements regarding this initiative and identify the correct statement. So first of all, why are we studying about Satat? So recently an MOU has been signed between the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas and the leading oil and gas marketing companies like Reliance. So bahut sari oil and gas marketing companies aur jo Ministry of Natural Gas and Petroleum hai uske beech mein MOU hua hai. Aur ye MOU kyun hua hai? To establish 5000 compressed biogas plant with an investment of approximately 2 lakh crore. 2 lakh crore investment ke saath 5000 compressed biogas plant banaye jayenge under the Satat initiative, and for this this establishment, this MOU has been signed. Okay. And talking about Satat initiative, so Satat stands for Sustainable Alternative Towards Affordable Transportation, that's full form. It was launched in 2018 by the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. And remember, don't confuse between the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas and the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, because we are not talking about any renewable energy here. It is for the compressed biogas plants. Okay, so this is from the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas, which is currently headed by Dharmendra Pradhan. He is also the Minister for Steel, and it has a target of setting up of 5000 compressed biogas plant by the financial year 2021, that is till 31st March 2024. Okay, financial year 2024 tak 5000 compressed biogas plants lagaye jayenge under the Satat initiative that was launched in 2018 by the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. All right, and remember the full form also, Sustainable Alternative Towards Affordable Transportation. All right, so now let's come back to the question. So we have to identify the correct statement regarding Satat initiative. So Satat initiative was launched in 2017. No, it was not in 2017. It has a target of setting up of 5000 compressed biogas plant by 2024. Yes, this is absolutely correct. And it was launched by Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. So is it new and renewable energy? No, That's Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. So we have only one statement correct here, which means option A, only two will be the correct answer. And now guys, let's move on to the question number 4. On the occasion of World Fisheries Day, that was on 21st of November. 21 November was the World Fisheries Day. Which state was conferred with the best state award in fisheries sector among inland states? So guys, this was the very first time when the government of India conferred awards in the fisheries sector to the best states, to the best organizations and to the best districts. Okay, pehli baar fisheries sector mein awards diye gaye hain to the best performing states, to the best performing organizations and to the best performing districts. Okay, so these are the awards that have been conferred in the best states awards. And among the marine states, Odisha was number 1. Then among the inland state, it was Uttar Pradesh. Then among the northeastern and hilly state, it was Assam. Talking about the best district, so among the marine districts, Krishna district in Andhra Pradesh was ranked number 1. Then Kalahandi in Odisha, then Nagaon in Assam. In Odisha, Kalahandi district in the inland district, while Nagaon district among the northeastern and hilly districts. Okay. In talking about the best organization, so Tamil Nadu Fisheries Development Corporation Limited for the marine area, Telangana State Fishermen Cooperative Society for inland, and Assam Apex Cooperative Fish Marketing and Processes Federation Limited, that is for northeastern and hilly areas. Okay. So agar ye organization ka naam yaad ho jata hai, then that is well and good. Otherwise, there is not necessary. These names are not necessary. Just remember the names of the best states and best districts. Best states are Odisha, Uttar Pradesh and Assam. Then best districts are Krishna, Kalahandi and Nagaon. Alright. And here the question is asking about the awards among the inland states. So among the inland states, Uttar Pradesh guys was number 1. So option B will be the correct answer. But for the marine, it is Odisha. And among the northeastern and hilly state, it was Assam. That was number 1. And talking about Uttar Pradesh, Yogi Adityanath is the Chief Minister, Anandibai Patel is the Governor, and recently they have launched Ayush Kavach app. Ayush Kavach app. They are building a zoo in Gorakhpur. They are building a zoo in Gorakhpur, which will be named after the great freedom fighter Shahid Ashfaqullah Khan. And Gorakhpur terracotta figures. Gorakhpur terracotta figures recently got the GI tag. If you remember. Gorakhpur terracotta figures. And talking more about Uttar Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh guys was number 1 in the domestic tourism. Uttar Pradesh was number 1. Alright, and you will find Kadarnia Ghat Wildlife Sanctuary there, Kishanpur Wildlife Sanctuary you will find there. And there is only one national park in Uttar Pradesh, that is Dudhwa National Park, which is also a tiger reserve. Alright, and Kathak of course is a very important dance in Uttar Pradesh, Kathak. And we have Ras Leela also, and one more, Nautanki. So these are some basic information about Uttar Pradesh, and here the correct answer is what, option B, Uttar Pradesh. And now let's move on to the question number 5, which is the last question for today. So consider the following statements regarding the report of UNICEF titled Averting the Lost COVID Generation. So this report guys is about the impacts of COVID-19 on children. Okay, children ke upar COVID-19 ka kya impact hai, uske regarding this report has been released by UNICEF. So let's talk about this report. So this report title as Averting a Lost COVID Generation, and this report highlights the growing consequences of COVID-19 on the children. And talking about the facts, so according to this report, children and adolescents account for 1 in 9 reported COVID-19 infections. Puri duniya mein 9 mein se ek COVID-19 ke jo infections hain, उसमें से 9 में से एक जो है वो कौन है, चिल्ड्रन और एडोलेसेंट्स. एंड एज ऑफ बिगिनिंग ऑफ नवंबर 2020, 11% ऑफ द टोटल इंफेक्शंस वर देयर व्हिच आर फ्रॉम चिल्ड्रन एंड एडोलेसेंट कैटेगरी. एज ऑफ अक्टूबर 2020, 265 मिलियन चिल्ड्रन वर मिसिंग आउट स्कूल मीट्स ग्लोबली. देन देयर इज अ 40% डिक्लाइन इन द कवरेज ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन सर्विसेज फॉर चिल्ड्रन अक्रॉस द ग्लोब. 40% का डिक्लाइन आया है इन द न्यूट्रिशन सर्विसेज दैट वर प्रोवाइडेड टू द चिल्ड्रन. ओके, एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट इंडिया स्पेसिफिक डेटा, सो एज पर द डेटा फ्रॉम ICMR, 11.89% ऑफ टोटल इन्फेक्शंस आर अंडर 20 इयर्स ऑफ एज. 11.89% इन्फेक्शंस ऐसे हैं जो कि 20 साल से कम उम्र के लोगों को है. देन 1.5 मिलियन स्कूल क्लोजर्स हैव इंपैक्टेड 247 million children enrolled in elementary and secondary institutions. Alright, so that's guys a very huge number. An estimated 20 million children under 5 years of age are suffering from wasting, and over 40 million children are chronically malnourished. Okay, so these are the some basic facts from this report. And now let's come to the question. We have to identify the correct statements. Okay, so let's make the question here. You have to identify the correct statement here. Okay, so children and adolescents account for 1 in 9 COVID-19 infections. Yes, this is absolutely correct. In India, an estimated 20 million children under 5 years of age are suffering from wasting. This is also correct. And there is a 40% decline in coverage of nutrition services for children across 135 countries. This is also correct, which means all are correct will be the correct answer. Alright. So option E here will be the correct answer. And remember, in this question, you have to identify the correct statement. Alright. And talking about UNICEF, so UNICEF, it is headquartered in New York. Henrietta Fore is the executive director. Henrietta Fore, and recently Ayushman Khurrana was appointed as the ambassador for child rights. Alright, ambassador for child rights, Ayushman Khurrana was appointed by UNICEF. Okay, and guys, that's it for the session. I hope everything is clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.